Ibrox, Scottish Cup.
Yeah.
They don't come much bigger, do they?
No, huge game. Absolutely massive cup tie. You know, the players can't wait to get started. There's been plenty words spoken, words written, but now it's time for action. So we can't wait to get the boots on and get ready for the massive game against Rangers on Sunday.
I suppose in some ways, if we look back on it last week very briefly, I suppose in some ways it's almost fortunate that the game didn't go ahead last Sunday. In respect of Elgin don't have a defeat, or they're not going there on the back of defeat, and equally they're not going there on the back of a victory, which might have been even more damaging.
Well, that's right. We had high hopes last weekend that we could have definitely done something at Boroughbriggs. We could have caused an upset. This weekend's totally different. Scottish Cup tie, you know, huge advantage to them if it wasn't already in their favour. On their home patch, massive crowd, you know, overwhelming favourites to go and wipe the floor with Elgin City. But we've got you know, other ideas about that. We need to go out and give a good account of ourselves. The players are, you know, primed, they're ready, they're at a peak. So, you know, bring it on.
It's a game plan. I suppose the game plan is just to play like Elgin City,
yeah.
You know, as far as possible. Obviously, you have to make allowances for the quality of the opposition you're playing. But primarily, you want to see the players doing what they've been doing for the last 6 months.
Exactly. A game plan might alter slightly this weekend than it would have done, you know, the game gone ahead on Sunday there past. You know, we won't be so expansive in the first few minutes, but you know, our game plan is to get the maximum from the players that we've got, and that's playing, you know, at a high tempo, good pace, getting crosses in the box and putting their defenders under pressure. Yeah, it'll be tough to carry out these aspects of the game, but we plan to do it anyway.
Now, if we go back again as well to the cancellation on Sunday, how has that affected the players, or has it affected the players in any way in training this week?
The players have been so motivated, directed towards the cup tie, and it's our objective, it's the way we go about things. As soon as one game's finished, we learn from it, we move on very quickly, and you know, every focus is on the cup tie. Ibrox, Scottish Cup, doesn't come much bigger than this.
I suppose in the mindset of a footballer, it's not all that different from actually bouncing back from a defeat. I mean, I said earlier, it might be fortunate that we didn't play Rangers, we're not playing them on the back of a defeat. It's a similar mindset, really. What's happened, really, as far as a footballer's concerned, has got nothing to do with this particular game.
No, exactly right. I mean, you know, the players can only influence things on the pitch. We can't influence things too much off it, so it's up to us now to, you know, be ready for it. You know, we're at the spot, on the spotlight again, on the stage, you know, cameras, everything focused on Elgin City, so we'll turn this to positive. You know, let's hope that they're talking about us in glowing terms, and the football wise, the way we play, the way we approach things, professionalism of the players, and hopefully it'll rub off to everybody else, because you know, the support we've had from, you know, the real genuine supporters out there, from obviously Elgin City, but other clubs have their supporters that realise what the players have gone through, has been heartwarming, and we hope, you know, we use that as a positive to take into Sunday's account against Rangers.
I think it's encouraging as well that you mentioned that the feedback they get from supporters, and as you say, not just City supporters. I've had a lot of Rangers supporters send me emails this last week saying, look, we don't blame Elgin City for anything, you're welcome at Ibrox anytime. That's got to be pleasing.
It is pleasing. I mean, they welcomed us with open arms in the league game down at Ibrox early on this season. You know, and hopefully there'll be the same response, same reception this Sunday, because you know, everybody realises, you know, the players just go on there and perform. We need to put on a show, and that's what we intend to do it to the best of our ability, and you know, we will do our utmost to make everybody associated with Elgin City proud.
Is there a sense of irony, of course, that what's actually happened? Is there a sense of irony that it's Rangers that we happen to be playing in the Cup?
What a coincidence, eh? Yeah. You know, I said to the players that, yeah, obviously the world media want to follow Glasgow Rangers, but the reason that there's so much interest in TV and the press and everything else recently is because, you know, the players have put themselves up there to challenge Rangers. You know, they've challenged them in the third division, so why not put up a huge challenge in the Scottish Cup? A lot of people out there thinking it's a potential banana skin. I know that you know, it's miles away from that at the moment, but if we perform at our highest and some of them don't, it just narrows the gap a little bit, and you know, we may take every advantage we can take, any opportunities that we take, we must take them against Rangers, because you know, goal scoring opportunities don't come that frequent against big teams on their own patch. So any we get, we need to be clinical and take them and also keep the door shut at the other end.
What made me think there when you were actually saying that, of course, was that I was thinking back to Forest Mechanics in this very competition, indeed, when they played Rangers along the road there. And Forest could have actually looked at that game afterwards and said, well, have we taken our opportunities there? That could have been a really big result. So I suppose you could use that as a benchmark.
Exactly right. I mean, Forest put in a fantastic show. Charlie's team were outstanding on the day. On their own patch at Forest, so you know we've got to do what they did in terms of endeavour and everything else. And like you say, if we get an opportunity to score, then you know we need to be clinical. Okay, in theory, is putting it into practice, but we've worked extremely hard over the last week on our game plan, and the boys have, have been very hard working this week, attentive. They've been on a high, as you can imagine. So, yeah, Sunday, bring it on.
And I suppose what you want to actually take out of this game, quite apart from a win, of course, which would be rather nice, a replay wouldn't be too bad, although it would throw up a load of more questions, no doubt. But what we really want to take from this game more than anything is pride.
Yeah, that's pride, yeah. I mean, like I said before, some of the criticism directed at the club as a whole has been hurtful, very hurtful. The players want to give an account themselves, and let's say it's a fantastic stage, great opportunity. Let's make sure that people are talking in positives about us next week.
And to the fans, Ross, finally, what would you say to the supporters that's going to be travelling down to Ibrox again, pretty much the same as it would have been last week? Enjoy.
I mean, enjoy the occasion, get right behind us as you always do. Players are fighting on your behalf, and we'd like to thank you for their undoubted support and belief in us. So come and be vocal, make it known that you're there in force, and the players will respond to that, and we'll do everything we can to